Hi, welcome back, my dear students. In this lecture here, we are going to be refactoring our code a little bit. We're going to be condensing our code, making it into modular pieces, all right? Just like we did with custom functions. Basically, that's what we're doing right here. We're grabbing a whole bunch of code and putting it into functions, all right? We have our categories here working already, all right? So that's working. And let's go back to our categories.php right here. So we got all this code right here, right? You know, we have a lot of HTML here too, so refactoring is going to come very handy, all right? So all we are going to be doing here, we're going to be creating this file called function.php, which is very popular in CMSs. So I'm just going to right-click on admin. I'm going to make this file called functions.php, enter. We're going to open our PHP tags here, and you should know this by now because you took those foundations when we started the course. All right, so I'm going to go back to categories. I'm going to take all this code out of here, like this. All right, I'm going to go back to functions. I'm going to create a function here called insert categories. Categories, there we go. And I'm just going to paste all that code in there. And then I'm just going to grab this function here, name, go back to categories and place it right here. Put a semicolon right here and the end of that PHP tag. Condense my code a little bit more this way. And now we have a beautiful piece of code here, which is the name of the function calling our functions, right? With all the functionality behind the scenes. So now it says call to undefined function insert categories. All right, let's make sure that we save our functions.php file right here. All right, and come back again. Insert categories, line 40. Something's going on there. Let's just check it out. All right, make sure that this code is clean here. Let's go back to categories.php. And we have, it should be, oh, okay. One thing that you should not forget, which I forgot right now, is that we need to include this file, right? We need to make sure that it's available, functions.php, all right? So go to your admin header inside your admin folders and make sure that we include this file, all right? Just like this. So we want this to be functions.php, all right? And that's what it should be there. Functions, and we are in admin, and this is inside, actually it's inside, there we go, that's what it should be right there. All right, for those of you that don't have this OB start function, make sure that you put it right now. All right, this is something that we are going to be needing throughout our CMS. This is going to start output buffering. All right, you can look it up on php.net, but basically we're going to send some information in the headers. That's for more advanced users, but just put this OB start function right here just in case you don't have it. So let's go back here and let's check it out. Now it looks like it's working, right? Look at that, add category. Then we can test 3 and undefined connection. All right. One thing that we need to do, all right? Another thing, and that's good that I tested that out, is that we need to bring, our connection has to be global. So we need to write the global attribute, the global right here, keyword. And this is just going to make our connection variable global, all right? So make sure that you do that, and now it should work. There we go. Test 3, add category, and now we have another category there working, all right? So make sure that you have your global here. Every time you're using a function and you need a variable to be available, make sure you bring it in with the global keyword. All right, make sure that you include your PHP, your function.php file in here. All right, so make sure you have the OB start function also. We are going to be needing that later on. All right, so we are going to continue, all right, refactoring the rest of this. And I'm just going to show you a couple of them, and then you should be good, and you should be able to do it yourself on your CMS. All right, so thank you so much for watching this lecture. And I see you in the next one. Keep it up. Keep motivated. This is going to take you super far in life if you apply the knowledge. And I'm always here to support you. All right? Have a blessing day. Bye-bye.